I decided to explore some of the nightmares because that seemed more challenging, and I really like to challenge myself physically, mentally, spiritually, and kind of push myself to an edge, see how far I can push my body, push myself. For me, that is very exciting, and it was very challenging. The first time that I did the performance, I was in tears, and it was a very cathartic experience. And I think it was turned out to be a very beautiful and symbolic piece. I am very drawn into the erotic, to what is sexual, to discovering and exploring our sexual selves, to educating and documenting our sexual culture, to participating in other media projects that are also exploring sexuality, and especially queer sexuality and sexuality around BDSM cultures and queer cultures. I feel like it's really important for us to archive that culture and to get that information out there, to get that media out there. I'm always thinking about the girl that's left behind in Ohio. I grew up in a little tiny town called Loveland, Ohio, and in the middle of America, in the Midwest. And, you know, there wasn't really any kind of queer culture for me to connect with. I felt very isolated, and it was difficult for me to find that kind of connection. So I'm always thinking about the people who are left behind and aren't in super amazing urban areas like New York or San Francisco or Paris or Berlin, where people can be themselves and where people can find more of that kind of connection. When I hear from young feminists who are in Ohio, in Indiana, in small towns that are finding connection and finding empowerment through the films that I'm doing and through the performances that I'm doing, and that are realizing that sex can be a very empowering thing. And something that we can take control of, and that we can enjoy, and that we can be just as much of a feminist by having control of our sexuality and expressing ourselves fully.